Time to feed the trolls. Season 4.
Hello, this is Cute Fuzzy Weasel, and it's time once again to feed the trolls. And welcome to Season 4. Yes, I've been doing this for 4 years. Well, technically 3 years. It'll be 4 years at the end of 2015. I've been doing this for 3 fucking years. My life is full of promise. Anyway, we're gonna kick 2015 off with a shorter troll video from a very personal troll of mine because he fuck him! I mean, we're gonna start off 2015 with an asshole. I mean, Pat McCrory. Someone who has some personal value to me because he's fucking up the state that I live in!
Hi, I'm Governor Pat McCrory.
Well, I didn't vote for you!
This past year, we tackled some very complex problems.
Yeah, I guess a waste disposal unit that's been rusted through on the bottom and falls over into a river is a pretty complicated problem.
And made some difficult decisions.
Pat McCrory's take on making difficult decisions. Pat, we've got a massive hole in the side of the ship! We are taking on water fast!
Okay, I have an idea. Go to the storage locker.
Yeah, yeah.
And then have an elect committee meeting on figuring out where the duct tape rolls are. I figure if we have one of these meetings within the next couple of months or so, we might be able to get the duct tape out, and that should keep us going through to 2017.
Because people are hurting.
Yes, I would imagine it would hurt to drink poison water.
Not enough people in North Carolina are working.
Because they've died of water poisoning. I mean, there's not enough jobs.
And we need jobs.
Yes, we do need jobs. Which is why I've elected to expand North Carolina's industrial state with the Koch brothers, who aren't actually going to bring us any new jobs, but they will bring me lots of money.
At times, we had to endure short-term pain for long-term gain.
Think about it, guys. If we just endure a few hundred generations of drinking fracking fluid, eventually we'll evolve to tolerate it.
And during this year, I've traveled the state listening to you.
Help me, Pat. I can't breathe. They're spraying pig shit into the air. Don't worry. I will repeal Obamacare for you.
And it's clear what we must do in order to unleash our resources for North Carolina's economic revival.
Learn how to spawn tornadoes to destroy low-income neighborhoods. That way we can bulldoze over those neighborhoods and create more oil wells.
So let's look at where we started. When I had the great honor of being sworn in as your governor, North Carolina's unemployment was the fifth highest in the nation at 9.5%. Today, it's down to 8%.
Wow, 8%? Golly gee, that sure is a glorious number.
And this Christmas season, 80,000 more North Carolinians are collecting a paycheck.
No thanks to you.
And speaking of paychecks, North Carolinians will keep more of their hard-earned money thanks to historic tax reform. On January 1st, the innovative tax reform plan we signed into law will allow you to keep more of your money in your wallet.
If you're a millionaire.
Plus, it'll make North Carolina more competitive.
Yeah, more competitive in the same way that a Chinese sweatshop is more competitive than any factory stateside.
And attracting new businesses to come to our state.
Coke Industries doesn't count.
Next year, we'll build on the progress we made this year.
Bigger, more glorious industrial disasters as far as the eye can see.
In revitalizing our economy, streamlining government, improving our children's education.
By allowing more conservative and creationist dogma in the classroom, we are ensuring that future generations are just as screwed up as us.
And rebuilding our transportation infrastructure.
Yes, over the next 25 fucking years!
We all want a better North Carolina.
A grayer, more desolate North Carolina, devoid of those pesky trees and run on clean burning coal. And we'll be able to get a hold of all of that just as soon as I'm done putting all the Moral Monday people in jail.
We must respect our different paths to reach that goal and find a consensus where we can.
Principally by ignoring the minority party during our budgetary meetings, but you know, that's consensus.
Now, during next year, I'll continue to surround myself with problem solvers
of the same right-leaning persuasion
to find long-term solutions.
Remember our multi-generational mutation plan. In fact, if you guys could also work on advancing your flight capability, that would be awesome too.
To improve the lives of everyone in North Carolina.
But climate change is still a myth.
You know, Chancellor Franklin, a farmer from Madison County, has given us all an example to follow. most of his crops were damaged by floodwaters that hit western North Carolina earlier this year. When I met Mr. Franklin outside his storm-ravaged home, he didn't greet me with a complaint. Instead, he handed me a bag of cucumbers from what little crops he had left, and he wanted to know, how was I doing?
You know, that Franklin dude does kind of sound like a real upstanding kind of guy. Why ain't he governor?
This is the strength of North Carolina.
Despite you, yes.
And I want to bottle up Chancellor Franklin's compassion, work ethic, and incredible resilience, and bring it back to Raleigh.
Bottle it up in a big bodily barrel of tar sands compassion. A big bodily tar sands compassionate rusty barrel, and leave it next to a stream or something where it can fill the world with compassion.
Working together, we can ensure that North Carolina's best days are ahead. Finally, First Lady Anne and I want to wish you and your family a very Merry Christmas, and may 2014 be a prosperous and healthy new year.
It sure was, Pat. It sure was. Anyway, that was Pat McCrory. If you have any trolls you want me to feed, list them in the comments below. I promise I'll listen to this. This was just a personal thing I had to get off my chest. Don't forget to subscribe and check out the other videos I've done. And as always, have a good day.
Hand that to me and see if you can toss it back up here.
You aren't serious.
I am serious. I want to see... Look at that.